unable, when he was unable to manage this.
Within how many days? He just said that.
What you need
for like 24
you
days.
Sir, you said something earlier on and I want to call your attention.
Call my attention to it, sir.
Right now, when they couldn't manage the factionalized NPDP, this one came forward, how reform the APC. If it is, if this APC, rAPC is not well managed, don't be surprised. Another faction will still come up. Private is going to land with my team, it's guided APC.
But no, having said that, I disagree with you.
I expect the leadership to have managed the factionalized
caucus.
To start it
right to remind you.
Private, the response they got.
Was not
the response, was not
let me remind you, sir, that I made a statement. I said these agitations were on even before the convention. A lot of people are thinking that everything will explode. People will decamp on the day of the election.
Let us give this new administration time to see.
But they are not giving them time. If that is
it depends on yours.
We are talking of just within a week, less than a week.
Sir, are you aware that Shomoye, since he got inaugurated, he has been meeting people
on
the response was not really assuring. That was what that led to this emotion.
So you want them to give them response that okay, we'll give you automatic etiquette for this, we'll give you this. There are all these cases against you.
If you read what the communique issued by this RAPC, their statement, go and read it. And see the reasons.
But those reasons are not legit.
You understand? You cannot say they are not. Every politician has one cardinal point to himself, which is your interest. So if your interest is circumvented, you don't have another choice than to.
Let's give Comrade Onaolapo of Tunji. Sir, we have 30 seconds.
I will start. I mean, my time is very small.
Okay.
See, leadership, right? Why we have a lot of issues at hand today is as a result of the leadership that we have. And why? Why did I say this? You see, Nigerians are not used to what is happening. Sorry to say. They are not used to it. How we are used to for years, 16 years, PDP ruling. Is that somebody just sit down and write something and everybody make it?
Can we do away with people?
And all these things failed. What do you want us to do? They will tell them to go. And now if Nigerians are saying,
did you even tell them to go? They are the one that.
What we even want is this. You see, rAPC, I've said it, is not a problem to APC. They should try their own might as well. They should try their own. Like Galadima said yesterday that he gave Buhari 70% of his votes with a nod. Let him try. Now, let him try. He can contest. He can join. We have 36 or more than many parties. Mm-hmm. Let them align with the party and let people see their strengths.
Or the
So, in this, the formation of rAPC is nothing to worry about.
I've said it. Okay. I've said it by the initial opening remarks. It is irrelevant. It's just being politicized and keep talking so that we say, you know what I plan? Mm-hmm. What I plan is 2019 is coming. Mm-hmm. So it will look as if PDP fashionalized before the election. Now APC too is fashionalizing before the election. It's rubbish.
Okay. Viewers, we know you have your feedbacks. We will give you your time later. But meanwhile, let's go for a quick commercial break and we'll be right back. Thank you.
Viewers, at home. Yes. Glue your eyes to no other station except Ifako-Ijaiye Television. That is what everybody watch now. Don't touch the dial. Ifako-Ijaiye TV at www.ifakoijaiyetv.com.
Have you subscribed to our YouTube channel? If you haven't, please log on to youtube.com and search for Ifako-Ijaiye Television. Click the red button. And please do not forget to thumb up. You can also connect with us on any of our social media platforms. Website www.ifakoijaiyetv.com, Twitter at ifakoijaiyetv, Facebook ifakoijaiyetv Lagos, Instagram ifakoijaiyetv, email address ifakoijaiyetelevision@gmail.com. My name is Mustapha Damola and I endorse Ifako-Ijaiye Television. Ifako-Ijaiye Television, the pride of the people.
Ifako-Ijaiye Television. Ifako-Ijaiye Television. Gbangba la shanta awo ki lumo Oluwa lo fi ran wa ade okin ojo teye keye.
E ma wo Ifako-Ijaiye Television. Make sure you wo. E ma wo Ifako-Ijaiye Television. www.ifako-ijaiyetelevision.com. Thank you.
You're welcome back, dear viewers. Thank you before we go on for staying tuned to us on this program, Politics and Perspectives on Ifako-Ijaiye Television. And the topic we have been discussing with our panelists today is the formation of a reformed All Progressive Congress, that is APC. And the question now is it the end of the road for this rAPC? Or is it a roadblock for PMB's second term ambition? So we've been asking questions and our panelists have been providing good answers to them, although they disagree. Sometimes they agree sometimes, which is very, very normal. The question I now have as a follow-up to all those ones that we've asked is this. Some people believe that the opposition, especially the PDP, has not realized the fact that Nigerians now vote for personality, not party, and that so far their party has no outstanding personality. Do you agree? Let me read that question again. Although I'm starting with Engineer Shomoye this time around. The question says, some people believe that the opposition generally, especially the PDP, has not realized the fact that Nigerians now vote for personality and not for party. And that so far, the opposition led by the PDP has no outstanding personality. personality, especially that can match the integrity of PMB. Sir, you agree?
Totally disagree.
Okay. Why?
Thank you. It's when I hear people saying what is a credible alternative to Buhari, I just laugh at their ignorance. Because we, for God's sake, we are a country of over 180 million. How do you tell Thai the destiny of a nation and a man? And besides, this man has contested 3 times with his personality and he lost. The fourth one that is now being fortunate to be the president was because he formed alliance with some other stakeholders. But having said that, that means some people believe that PDP does not have credible candidates. Not even only PDP. So many other parties.
There are so many other
personalities on
there. We have some special landings, so we interrupt.
Yeah, just who are those people? We have quite a lot of personalities that are much, much more credible than what we have now, that would have given us good governance. In that case, right now, you understand? In any party.
You see,
that is where you are getting it from. As long as a government or an administration does not follow the rule of law, that is the genesis of the problem we have. Right now, it is not yet time for campaigning. People are still doing on the groundwork. You can't tell me PDP is bereft of a candidate with the interest being shown by quite a lot of people like quite a lot of people are showing interest. Even a Nigerian qualified, yes. We have people like Mogadu, what's his name? This CBN former director, Mogadu something. We have people like even Shomoye. We have quite a lot of people. Even me, I can contest. I don't have the interest right now. So it is something that, look, the elder we get that our destiny as a nation is not tied around one individual. Buhari, to me, my personal opinion, is the worst personality to govern us at this present time.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much. Although I disagree with that, then I want to agree with you in one aspect, that we cannot tie the destiny of this country around just one person. So, Buhari, president, is not the omnipotent, is not this or that. But as far as I'm concerned, so far, there's no credible alternative that has come
up. It depends on what
you are doing. No, that's what I'm
saying. It depends on what you are
doing. Sir, you are interrupting me too.
Now, if someone is contesting, right, You have 19 northern states. You have 17 southern states. If you are talking about the state that the regions that make up Nigeria. Mm-hmm. And in the north, where you have President Muhammadu Buhari, as of today, people will tell you so many stories on internet and the rest. But in the north today, it's only if President Muhammadu Buhari is not contesting. In as far as he comes up that he's contesting, he has large followers. And that doesn't, you know, give those people that are in the south that they cannot come up with somebody. But the issue that is that there are a lot of coalitions. Southwest, we know how the elections will go. So the most important thing that we need, if PDP are really sure of bringing out a credible candidate, there are a lot of people that are credible that can handle the affair of the country even better than Muhammadu Buhari. But the machinery in that party
will not allow
some people to even get there. Because why? Because, you know, when PDP was planted, it was planted on a good motive. But later was hijacked by looters and thieves and criminals. Sorry to use those words. But now, at the end of the day, it's even hard for them to trust themselves.
Okay.
2015, one second. 2015, when Buhari wants to come on board, Buhari has contested four times.
One second is good.
Yes, I'm sorry. Buhari has contested four times. But 2015, when he formed an alliance with the relevant people from the southwest, he got there. And he will still get there.
Okay. Thank you very much. Comrade Chief Samuel Olusola Arowolo.
Thank you very much. Well, the question says that PDP has not realized that people do not vote for personality, people vote for personality, not for party. I disagree with that.
Okay.
If you want to draw this hypothesis, let Buhari leave APC today to go to another party, we fail woefully. Despite the fact that people know his pedigree as no non-compromising person. You know, what we have been shouting for in Nigeria is corruption. And we see this person that is trying his possible best. If he decides to leave APC today, then I want to go and continue with that corruption war in another party, we fail. People will not vote for him.
That's another perspective.
People
perspective
are not voting for personality in Nigeria. Rather, we are voting for money. People have started, I read in the newspaper in the Ekiti State that people have been giving back of right and say there's too much structure, and so on and so forth. And these people, it is where there is money that they will vote for. But the only prayer in Nigeria is that it be a time when it be like those advanced countries, when people will vote for personality, not party. Somebody was even telling me sometimes ago that in Lagos State, for example, if a dog is presented as a gubernatorial candidate, people will still vote for that dog.
Under
APC. Just to show you that
their loyalty to the
party is not party.
Okay. We still have another question before we go for another.
Yes, the last, I think this is just the last question. Why is it that the so-called rAPC have no consensus on where to decamp to? It is public knowledge that some of them have legs in PDP, SDP, and some others in ADC.
Sir, can we start with you, sir?
Let's start with you.
Okay, no, I don't want to start with you. Maybe let's start with you.
The RAPC, to my own perspective, right, is that they are marketers.
Okay.
Yes, about to say they are marketers. Okay. They just like to market themselves.
Okay.
And maybe some people will buy them up.
Mm.
That's how I feel.
Okay.
Because now, For them to even associate themselves to a party is a problem for them. So what they are trying to do is that they want to put these thorns to us. Maybe some people, some aggrieved people in the states, the local government, factions, that they want to form a faction. Like when you have issues in some states during the Congress, maybe some people just want to pull out and say, we are now in Lagos. So, like some factions in Lagos are not happy with the party chairman. Say now we are now out of the rAPC. But that will not sell. Because when you are a marketer, you want to market something to the people. Nigerians are wise. They know that this set of people that arrange themselves to form the rAPC don't have any political relevance. I'm saying it. If they do, they should go to their state and contest elections.
Okay.
Simple as that.
Okay. Let me now go to Comrade. Please, 30 seconds.
Thank you very much. To say they don't have a consensus platform in which to move to is not true.
Okay. Okay. What's the consensus?
You see, strategically, when you want to fight a war, you just don't put all your arsenal at the forefront.
That's right.
You understand? And I can assure you, before they even came to the public, they've already perfected their plans. All this one we are just saying, but in this few days' time, you will see if it is not being resolved. There are quite a lot of, they are beautiful bride, and that's why they want to go as a block. They are not going individually. So no political party that will see a block coming forward will not accept them. But negotiations are ongoing as to where to
go.
Sorry, don't
interrupt him.
In which case,
they are still negotiating with PPP, SDP.
I am not a member.
No,
because of APC. So it will be extremely difficult for me to know the faction. Look, I want to say something. Let's point of correction. The more you keep saying there is no faction in APC,
there is no.
The worse for that party. The earlier the party realizes that, look, things are going well. Because you are not a stakeholder in that party. You are just a.
Let's give our chief comrade, Arowolo, time to say just 30 seconds.
And that will make lecture. God bless you.
God bless you.
And the viewers, God will bless you.
Amen.
The new reform APC.
All right.
Like what my comrade Onaolapo has said earlier on, I said they are prostitutes. Yes. When their expectations are not met in APC, they now decide to opt out. Then they want to float. So that people will start coming to beg them. It's not me, it's not you that will be begging them to come up on board. It's the political party. They believe that when they have them in their, in their flock, they will to use them to sell. But even though they use them to sell, they are party, not party ideology. Because in Nigeria today, there is nothing like ideology. Yes, anybody who just put a party and draw, and we have a lawyer in the audience here, they've just draft rubbish, believing that people will, no matter how the ideology is good, people will not vote for that ideology, political ideology. They vote for, in this program, I've been hammering my something on money. Because of what I've experienced. So the
ARPP, ABC,
they are prostitutes. That's my own.
Okay, and we'll be right back after this break. And when we come back from the break, we'll go for the closing remarks by our panelists.
Ifako-Ijaiye Television.
Ifako-Ijaiye TV. Keep watching, guys.
Bang bang, la shanta, awo kilumo. Oluwa lo fi ran wa ade okin ojo teye keye.
Yes, yes, yes. Ile iṣẹ amóhùnmáwòrán kan tàn warawara nísìnyí tí gbogbo ayé ń wo Ifako-Ijaiye Television. O ni màmá Arísí ń wò, màmá Abiola wò, ìyá táwa ń wà, bàbá Bankole ń wò, gbogbo wa a wo Ifako-Ijaiye Television ní www.ifakoijaiyetv.com. Máa yí kó rẹ o, máa wò lọ.
Have you subscribed to our YouTube channel? If you haven't, please log on to youtube.com and search for Ifako-Ijaiye Television Blitz. Click the red button to subscribe and do not forget to thumb up. You can also connect with us on any of our social media platforms, website www.ifakoijaiyetv.com, Twitter at Ifako-Ijaiye TV, Facebook Ifako-Ijaiye TV Lagos, Instagram Ifako-Ijaiye TV, email address ifakoijaiyetelevision@gmail.com. My name is Mustapha Adabola. I am those Ifako-Ijaiye Television. Ifako-Ijaiye Television, the pride of the people.
Ifako-Ijaiye, Ifako-Ijaiye Television. Ifako-Ijaiye, Ifako-Ijaiye Television. Gbangba la shanta awo ki lumo. Oluwa lo fi ran wa ade okin ojo teye keye.
Thank you for staying tuned to your favorite television station, Ifako-Ijaiye Television. We are still on your program, Qualities and Perspectives. We've had a lot of comments, perspectives from our panelists. To every journey, there's always an end.
Sure.
Yes, and the topic we are still talking about is end of the road for rAPC or roadblock for President Muhammadu Buhari's second term ambition. I think right now we need to go on our opening closing remarks. Yes. So I will give it to Comrade Prince Taiwo Shomoye.
Oh, thank you very much. To start with my closing remark, I want to correct an impression. Two impressions now.
Okay.
That people that are trying to move away from the party are prostitutes, political prostitutes.
Mm-hmm.
And again, that probably the using factor for their moving away is money. No. You don't say they are prostitutes because this same APC party in 2014 accepted some dissenting voices
from
other parties. You did not send them away. That they were prostitutes, don't come to our place.
What did they send them away? Hoping that
they made use of those bad prostitutes. You use them. Five governors coming under NPDP. You never send them away. That's one. Number two, when it comes to internal politics, as in inter-party politics,
I'm taking that as a opportunity. Yeah,
it's more of interest. Interest is not necessarily money. It could be post. This, I said earlier in the program, the outcome of this factionalized section, rAPC, reformed or deformed or whatever you call it, or misguided APC, is as a result of the crisis from those congresses that were not well managed.
Okay.
So my own advice and closing remark is this.
Good.
A house that is built on a rock will stand firm.
Good.
The one that is built on loose sand will not last test of time. APC, if they know they still want to continue as a dominating factor in Nigerian politics, need to take this as serious as possible. Need to take this thing up and not just wish it away that way. They can go. The consequence will even be worse than what happened to PDP in 2015.
There is one thing we just have to understand. I agree with you with some of your comments. Then nobody said they were prostitutes, but they could still have been prostitutes.
No, they've been tagged prostitutes by panelists.
But now, that's what I'm saying. That then.
Oh, when they migrated, they were not prostitutes.
No, they could have been prostitutes.
When they compromise other parties, destroy a party to call me.
Don't interrupt me, sir. So, but now, it's not proven, and nobody can even prove it that they are prostitutes. We are calling them, even we probably attack them prostitutes, and we agree because of their behavior. Do you understand?
Where they behave before?
Yes, then again, what Chief Comrade Arowolo said about money is that the electorates were bought with money. It's not saying that these people are going because of money. No. And even, let me even tell you, in this, the campaign of a team, money is involved.
And this coalition?
Cash and sure, carry. Sure. Money is involved. It's what I know.
That's your own perspective.
No, most people's perspective.
How do you read
most
people? So, if you use money to buy the MPP there.
So, you take.
You then use money to buy the MPP.
So, you don't know?
I did not know.
So. Okay, now you're going. Now you're going. Let's
give it to Ijaiye.
Okay, you're close to
my I want to be very fast about it. You see, when five governors and some notable people from PDP pulled out
from PDP, yeah.
pre-2015 election, you can see the level of impunity that was done to them. You can remember Taiwo was the speaker of House of Assembly. House of Rep. You see what happened to him.
Yes.
Amechi was the governor of River State.
Yes.
You see how he was humiliated. Even during the election that brought in fire machine, you can see how the military blocked road for governors that are coming to that place. So this is a template for you to see how ruthless PDP were then. And what even those people, they might not want to join another party. But with what has played down to them, have you heard them when Jonathan or Sambo engage these people in any meeting for reconciliation?
No.
But now, if you are comparing then and now, it's a different issue. You can see what the APC now have done to have some reconciliation with those NDP. But out of the NDP, NPDP. You will see from the NPDP, some people are telling us that we are not part of what is happening.
And this is going to be mentioned, he's not a member of RAPC.
He's not, there are
many of them. You
know, so now, when you now see some elements that just branded themselves, that's why I ask the question. Have you seen any governor? Have you seen any senator? Have you seen any House member that has associated this?
Ifako-Ijaiye Television.
late. I see the red button there, click, subscribe.
And also, you can join us on our website. That is www.ifakoijaiyetv.com.
And our Facebook account is Ifako-Ijaiye TV Lagos.
You can also follow us on Twitter at Ifako-Ijaiye TV.
And on Instagram, we are Ifako-Ijaiye TV.
You can partner with us. Send us your opinions, your views, your perspectives. Probably not only on these politics and perspectives or any of our programs.
Yeah.
You can easily forward your mail, your messages to ifakoijaiyetelevision@gmail.com.
Yes. And in case you want to call us or you want to WhatsApp us, the numbers, the first one is 0805-196-4461. 0805-196-4461.
And also 0773-743-9891. 0773-743-9891.
And before we leave, we want to really appreciate those who have been working behind the camera. They've been so wonderful. Emmanuel Aroboto, thank you very much. Siwa Femi Peter, we thank you. And we also thank Samuel Faluji for the good job that you guys have been doing. My name is still Samuel Mustapha, and
I am still Comrade Oluwaseun Akintande. Before we go, consider this thought.
Okay.
A man who has confidence in himself can also get confidence in others.
Yes. We'll see you next time. God bless you.